too, Alfred. But none seemed quite right. She put on a pretty red dress and looked in the mirror. Then she screamed. Her mother ran into the room. And she screamed too. She cried. This was certainly true. Camilla was striped from head to toe. She looked like a rainbow. Miss Cream felt Camilla's forehead.
Do you feel all right?
She asked.
I feel fine. Just look at me.
Camilla answered.
You get back in bed this instant. You're not going to school today.
Her mother ordered. Camilla was so relieved. She didn't want to miss the first day of school, but she was afraid of what the other kids would say, and she had no idea what to wear with those crazy stripes.
You are who you are, like it or not. God made you special and he loves you a lot.
That afternoon, Dr. Bubble came to exam Camilla.
Most extraordinary. I've never seen it before. Are you having any coughing, sneezing, runny nose, aches and pains, chills, hot flashes, dizziness, drowsiness, shortness of breath, uncontrollable twitching?
He asked.
No, I feel fine.
The next day was a disaster. Everyone at school laughed at Camilla. They called her Camilla Crayon. And that of the woman lollipop. She tried her best to act as if everything were normal, but when the class met the Pledge of Allegiance, her stripes turned red, white, and blue, and she broke out stars. The other kids thought this was great. One yelled out, "Let's see some purple polka dots."
I'm sorry, Mrs. Cream. I'm going to have to ask you to keep Camilla home. He's just too much of a distraction. And I've been getting other phone calls from the other parents. They think those stripes may be contagious.
He said Camilla was so embarrassed she couldn't believe that 2 days ago everyone liked her, that nobody wanted to be in the same room with her.
Her father, trying to make her feel better, he asked.
No, thank you.
Sighed Camilla. What she really wanted was a nice plate of lima beans, but she had been laughed at enough for one day.
You are who you are, like it or not. God made you special and he loves you a lot.
Hello? Yes, I see. I think I better bring the specialist. We'll be right over,
said Dr. Boma to Mr. Cream on the phone. About an hour later, Dr. Boma arrived with 4 people in long white coats. He introduced them to the Creams. Specialist went to work on them. Squeezed, jabbed, tapped, and tested. It was very uncomfortable.
Well,
it's not
the mumps,
or
the measles. Definitely not chicken pox or sunburns,
replied the specialist.
Try these.
Said the specialist. They each handed her a bottle filled with different colored pills. Then they filed out the front door, followed by Dr. Bunker.
That night, Camilla took her medicine. It was awful. When she woke up the next morning, she did feel different. But when she got dressed, her clothes didn't fit right.
She looked in the mirror, and there, staring up at her, was a giant multicolored pig with her face on it. Miss Cream called, but this time, instead of the specialist, he brought the expert. Mr. Moon had one of the fine scientific minds in the land. Once again, Camilla was poked and prodded, looked at, and listened to. The expert wrote down lots of numbers. Then he huddled together with Dr. Bumble and whispered. Mr. Melon finally spoke.
It could be a virus,
he announced with authority suddenly. Fuzzy little particles appeared all over Camilla.
Possibly some form of bacteria,
said Mr. Melon. Pop squiggly little bacteria toe.
Or it could be a fungus.
And in Mr. Melon, instantly, Camilla was covered with different colored fungus blotches. The expert looked at Camilla, then each other. Said the expert, but the expert didn't have a clue. Reports from every channel were outside her house telling the bizarre case of the incredible kid. Soon a huge crowd was camped out on the front lawn. Creams were swamped with all kinds of remedies from psychologists, allergists, herbalists, nutritionists, psychics, an old medicine man, a guru, and even a veterinarian. Each so-called cure only added to poor Camilla's strange appearances until it was hard to even recognize her. And feathers and a long coat of tail, but nothing worked. One day, a woman who called herself an environmental therapist claimed she could cure Camilla, she said. Camilla groaned. Slowly, she started to melt into the walls of the room. Her bed became her mouth, her nose was a dresser, and her paintings were her eyes. The therapist screamed and ran from the house. He opened. She went into Camilla's room and looked around.
My goodness, what we have here is a bad case of stress. One of the worst I've ever seen.
She said with a shake of her head. She pulled a container of small green beans from the bag. She said, Mrs. Cream, the old woman replied.
Of course not. There's no such thing as magic beans. These are just old plain lima beans. I bet you like some, wouldn't you?
You are who?
she asked Camilla. Camilla wanted a big, heaped plate full of lima beans, more than just about anything. But she was still afraid to admit it. She said, said the old woman. Sadly, she put the beans back in her bag and started toward the door.
You are who you are, like it or not, God made them so good.
The bean left after eating them was nothing compared to what they'd been going through. She finally couldn't stand it. She cried, popping the old woman's mouth, popping a handful of beans into Camilla's mouth, and said,
Yeah! Said
Camilla. Suddenly, the branches, feathers, and squiggly tails began to disappear, and the whole room swirled. When it stopped, there stood Camilla, and everything. She patted Camilla on the head and she went outside and vanished into the crowd. Afterward, Camilla wasn't quite the same. Some of the kids at school said she was weird, but she didn't care a bit. She ate all the lima beans she wanted, and she never even had a touch of the stripes again. Because
you are who you are, like it or not. God made you special and he loves you a lot.
God loves you just like you are. Why don't we share some verses that tell us how much God loves us? Maestro, start the music.
Oh boy, here we go again.
Psalm 139.